Hey friends! In today's very short tutorial, we'll be making a toggle component. It's also known as the switch component, and we'll be adding an animation to it so that it actually toggles. So here, the moment I press on it, you can see that the knob expands a little bit, signifying the direction in which it's going to go to, and the moment I release, it switches over, and obviously the other way around. So to get started, let's create a new Figma file and make sure that you have some colors on hand that you'll want to use for the text, for the track background color, kind of like a grayish, and a green for the active state. All right, so I do have some colors here, and we're going to begin by creating the label for the toggle. So I'll create a text layer, and this one, let's just say toggle label, and I'm going to switch the text and make it much smaller, maybe 18 pixels, and I'll switch the color to this very dark gray. So this is our label, and then we're going to create our track, and our track is going to be around 56 pixels wide and 32 pixels tall. Let's zoom in, and we'll give it the full border radius. And this is going to be our off state, so we'll give it a background color of gray 200. Then we'll create our knob, or also known as the thumb, and we'll make it 28 by 28. And the fill is going to be white. And then for the position, we will keep it maybe around 2 pixels from the top and the bottom and 4 pixels from the left. And then another thing that we'll want to add are a couple shadows. So our first one, we'll update the blur to maybe 8 and then Y value to 3, how far down it is. And we're not shifting it over on the X axis. So we'll keep it a 0 here. And then we'll make it much softer, maybe 10%. And then we'll add another one on top. This one will be much smaller. So like this. As you can see, even though this one is pretty small, when I toggle this on and off, it does add some emphasis to the knob. And lastly, we're just going to rename this one to the knob. And this one is going to be our track. And then we can combine these two together and we'll call them toggle. Now we're going to combine our two layers, the toggle and the label, and we'll do Shift plus A to add on the layout, and then I'll decrease the spacing to 12, and we do want them to be centered. And from here, we can start adding our different variants for the pressed interaction and for the active state. So first, we're going to do our pressed interaction when the toggle is off. So for this one, the way we'll modify, we're just going to select the knob here. And as you can see, I also selected just this one point here. So just make sure that this one is selected. And after that, you'll be able to just use your arrow keys to move it like up, down, wherever you want. What we are going to do, we're just going to shift it over to the right, maybe by 4 pixels. And that's going to be our press state, like this. And then to add an actual interaction, you're going to go over to the prototype tab. And we're going to do this on the whole frame here, so both the label and the toggle, just a much bigger area to click. So we'll add an interaction here, and we'll do it while pressing. We don't want it to be instant, we want it to be smart animate, and we'll switch the easing function to is in and out, and we'll make it somewhat faster, so 200 milliseconds. And now we can test this out. As you can see, the moment I press on this, the state switches to this press state, and when I release, it goes back to its original state. Now we're going to go back and add a couple more variants. So our next one is going to be the on state, and you just want to make sure that you're not preserving any prototype interactions when you're copying this over. And what we're going to do for this one is we'll bring the knob all the way over to the right and just make sure it's 4 pixels from the right side. And then we'll also want to update our background color from gray to maybe like green 500. And then we'll add an animation to go from our press state. And for this one, the moment the mouse is up, we're going to switch it to the on state. And we're also going to do smart animate, and we'll make this one much faster, 120 milliseconds. So now we can go back and test this out. So the moment I press on it, it kind of, the knob switches its shape. And the moment the mouse comes up, it switches over. But then if I were to press and then maybe decided that I didn't want to do that anymore and move my mouse over, it would not switch to the on state. Now we're going to return to our Figma file and we're going to add our last variant. So I'll copy this frame here and we're going to again select the ellipse and then make sure that we select this left point here and we're just going to move it over to the left 4 pixels. And then we're going to add our interaction. When you're pressing, we want to go to this press state here. And we just need to make sure that we update our timing and it's going to be while pressing. And then we'll connect the cycle. So we'll go from this variant to the one that we started with and we'll do it on mouse up. And again, we'll just update the timing. And now we can go back and forth. The very last thing that we have left to do is actually put all of this into a single component with variants. So we're going to do that now. First, I'm going to select all of our frames and rename them to toggle. And then I'll go ahead and create a component set. From here, we'll need to add a couple of properties. For our first one, we'll say active. And these two are going to be no. These two will be yes. Then we'll add another variant, which is going to be pressed. And these two are going to be pressed. And these two are no. And lastly, maybe we'll have some use cases where we don't want the label to be either in this exact position or to be this style. Anyway, we just want to be able to hide it. So I'm going to select all of the labels here. And I'm going to go to the layer. And I'll just call this one label and we'll keep it true by default. But then if I were to take an instance and turn the label off, as you can see, the label is now hidden. Now let's just grab an instance of an unpressed toggle and we can test this out. And fortunately, it behaves as expected. All right, so that's it for this short tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. I also hope that as you work on your project, that you are able to find some time to incorporate these small elements of delight, like we did with this knob here. We could have had just a simple unclick interaction where the knob just suddenly switches over to the other side. But instead, we did this pressing state where as you press on it, the shape of the knob slightly changes. And then it switches over. Also, if you have any examples of fun interactions that you enjoy, please feel free to share. Like always, I will leave the file to the Figma in the description of this video. And I'll see you in the next tutorial. Bye-bye.